This is the race you should want to see more than any other. Ferrari F12 versus Lamborghini Aventador versus Aston Martin 177. These are the dream cars of our times, made from stuff that hadn't even been discovered just a few years ago and developed by men with dashing, heroic names like Dario, Valentino, and Alan. Each one is V12 powered and capable of things that less than a decade ago would have landed you in a hedge and then in a hospital. They push the boundaries of what we've come to call fast. I would say they're among the fastest cars we'll ever see, but I won't. There will be faster cars one day very soon, remarkable as that might seem. But for now, just enjoy the glorious state of the art.
Thank you. These are the boom crooners of the supercar world. Clothed in something approaching more like a classic tuxedo than something from the catwalk, and so just that little bit more everyday. But no less appealing for that. Even its name, California, tells you all you need to know about Ferrari's easy-driving car. This is a car in which to enjoy the sunshine, to spend rather more time enjoying the scenery passing by than counting down the meters to the next braking point. The AMG version of the Mercedes SLK and the BMW Z4 S-Drive have no rear seats, but do have engines of impeccable pedigree and rather nifty folding steel roofs. Not as rare as the Ferrari maybe, but no less exciting. The Audi TT RS, meanwhile, is neither rare nor a convertible. It is, however, with its 2.5-litre, 5-cylinder rally quattro engine and 4-wheel drive, unquestionably exciting. But only when you want it to be. Which is what this group is all about.